What's up, guys? Nothingwired.com, and today we're at the launch of the Alpha 7 and Alpha 7 R. Now we're gonna give you a quick overview on both these cameras. You can see both these cameras look almost identical, apart from the lens, of course. The bodies are almost identical. Both are built with magnesium alloy for most part, and then you have rubber patches in places. Yeah, now let's check out the Alpha 7 R. Now, as I told you before, that the 7 and 7R looks almost identical. However, there are feature differences. Now, the 7 has a 24.3 MP sensor to start with. However, the 7R has a 36.4 MP sensor, and it does not have an optical low pass filter, which means that you might have more problems, but we've heard that that's considerably low because of the image processing engine, which is Bionz X, which both these cameras uses. That's Sony's latest image processing engine that, among other things, should correct the moiré to a large level. Also, it also tries to correct a lot of features like the softness that comes from small aperture and some other important things. So we'll look forward to testing that when these cameras come to our left for detailed review. Let's quickly give you an overview of the 7R. So you have a magnesium alloy body there. And then let's quickly take off the lens. By the way, the 7R comes only as a body only, and this is not the kit lens. It's a Carl Zeiss 55mm 1.8 lens. It's an FE lens. FE is a full frame E-mount lens that Sony has introduced along with this cameras. This you'll have to buy as an optional lens. It's pretty expensive too, being a Carl Zeiss. Now the 7R will come as a body only. You can see the full frame sensor there. It has 36.4 in full frame mode, and will come down to about 15 MP in cropped mode. And that's the E-mount, so you'll be able to, of course, use the FE lenses that were introduced right now, and also the E-mount lenses of the NEX series of camera. However, they will come as cropped, so you'll have an option of going to the crop mode on, off, or auto. If you keep it in auto, which is its default mode, then the camera will automatically go to a crop mode, 15 MP, and will give you a proper picture that you would have seen from when you clicked it from an APS-C sensor. However, if you put it on, then even on a full frame or on an FE or an alpha lens, you'll see a cropped image. And if you put it on off, then when you use an APS-C and when you use a lens meant for APS-C sensors, you will see heavy vignetting. You'll see all blacks, black circle around it, because that lens cannot cover the full frame sensor that's present on the 7R. Apart from that, the front side is almost identical to the Alpha 7. You have the IR receiver here, the command dial here, and we absolutely love the fact that you have one command dial on the front side, one on the back. That's very easy. You can easily use your thumb and this finger to operate them. So the top is as busy as usual. You have one custom button here, then your shutter release button, your power lever, and then your manual exposure control dial, and your mode dial with two custom settings there. Stereo mics. See, accessory hot shoe that can use your external flash or an external mic. There's a sensor mark and the speakers. Now you can easily use an external mic here, and it would be great for video, mainly because it has the audio jack for your external mic, but also as a bonus, it has a headphone jack for you to be able to monitor the sound. Now that's absolutely critical when you're recording a video, and we absolutely love them to have this. Then you have your usual HDMI and data transfer port. Now mind you, like the all the RX series, it does not come with, both the Alpha 7 and 7R do not come with an external wall adapter. You'll have to use your micro USB wall adapter that comes with your phone, or that will be supplied with this one, to charge these via body. So when you finish charge on one battery, you'll have to charge the camera by itself, and you cannot shoot while, you know, you cannot shoot with the camera while charging. On this side, you have the lone SD card slot Of course, with 36 MP, we would have liked a double card slots because this card will finish in almost no time. The 800E, which Sony says, which the sensor of which also is made by Sony, but Sony says it's a different sensor, that the photo size of that comes to about 50 MP. So your card will finish in no time. The backside, you have the tilting non-touchscreen, a 3-inch LCD screen. And you can view it from three angles, from top, from below, and the usual head-on. You have the EVF here, 100% coverage, the menu button, your second custom button, the other dial that I shown you before, your dedicated video button there, and then AF/MF switch, your FN button. So that's count for three, customized button, playback, delete, that also can double for another customized button, and then your multi-direction and pad that doubles as some functions like drive mode, display, and WB on the three sides. Below you have the tripod mount and your battery compartment. Now this uses the same battery as the Alpha 7080mAh battery. So that's about construction. They are very ruggedly built, although they look small, but they are no way fragile. They are very durable. They look very serious with straight lines, magnesium alloy, rubber patches here and there, and straight away tells you that this camera is meant for the serious image enthusiast. So that's about it. We'll have to check the image quality on 7 and 7R when they come to our left for complete review. Let's go and attach this lens. Now the 7 and 7R will be available in India in December sometimes with at least four of the FE lenses, and the body only of the 7R will be priced at about 1,24,000. There won't be any kit lens. You'll have to buy all the lenses separately with the Alpha 7R. Thank you.